probably.
And how long would that take?
It's hard to say right now.
Well, I mean, if we're dealing with terrorists, then they make another run, Charlie.
Larry has time booked in the computer lab. I mean, that could help us run this program much faster.
Call Larry.
When you first told me you wanted to run an advanced conditional probability distribution application, I was delighted. Naturally, I assumed we were about to attempt a model of my theory concerning the distribution of gravity waves.
Sorry, Larry.
But no, little did I realize my slender budgetary resources were being used to finance a UFO hunt.
I think the more accurate term is unexplained aerial event.
And you won't get to get to reimburse you, I promise. National security has to take priority.
Yes, thank you for being understanding.
You said this craft left no radio signature.
Nothing visible.
So what assumptions are we making for the program?
While the FBI has eliminated weather balloons, they've eliminated ultralight aircraft, helicopters, and military drones.
Which leaves us...
I think the highest probability is it's some kind of small piloted aircraft that was flying without a radar transponder, or one that was turned off.
Well, keep in mind, quantum physics maintains an infinite number of possibilities. This might have nothing to do with man or machine. Oh, this could be some sort of interdimensional event. Yes, it might even be a vehicle from another part of the universe using a type of propulsion we can't even begin to understand.
Okay, Larry. We'll try and factor that in as well.
Okay, you two can make your own jokes. The fact remains, we may not be
wrong. What was that?
That's the squish-squash program calculating the object's likely flight path.
It looks like the flight path of a mysterious little object has suddenly become much less mysterious.
This is the path of the object as calculated by the squish-squash algorithms.
And what happened to you?
The signal becomes a certain attraction. It's a very small hill.
Right.
But if we follow the projection of the data, flight takes us over the city.
Now, what is that on the map? That is right over the Staples Center.
Or right into it. Major sports venue, thousands of innocents, exactly the kind of high visibility soft target we've been worried about.
We should get a schedule of upcoming events at the Staples Center.
All right.
What we have is a small aircraft capable of penetrating densely populated areas without detection. Obvious dangers are is if it crashes into a building or, God forbid, disseminates a WMD. Wes has the good news.
What's she doing?
She stole a sucker and now she's trying to open it.
According to Professor Epps, craft took off from somewhere in here. What I'm calling the area of origin.
Assuming we're looking for a fixed-wing airplane, it would need a runway to take off from.
How many strips are in the area of origin?
One commercial, four recreational.
Savvy.
We need to cover them all. We track every single plane that
took
off.
You stole my sucker.
As many pilots as possible. And somebody had
he
to see.
He stole it.
Okay, let's do
he
it.
He took two of them. Oh, there she goes.